We want to solve the system of linear equations by graphing. To solve a system of equations, we want to find the x and y values that satisfy both of the equations, not just one of them. And to do this using the graphing method, we'll graph both lines on the same coordinate plane and then analyze the graph to determine the solution. Let's review what could happen when we graph two lines on the same coordinate plane. Well, the first possibility is the two lines intersect, as we see here. And since there's one point of intersection, we have one solution, and the solution would be the coordinates of the point of intersection. This type of system is consistent and the equations are independent. If we graph the two lines and they're parallel, there's no points of intersection, therefore there's no solution. And the system is inconsistent and the equations are independent. The last possibility is the two lines coincide, or they're on top of one another, so they have an infinite number of points in common, therefore there's an infinite number of solutions. And when this happens, the system is consistent and the equations are dependent. So going back to our example, let's graph the first line in blue. We have x plus y equals 4. Let's go ahead and make a table of values for that. Let's set x equals 0 and maybe x equals 2. Well, if x is 0, y would have to be 4. 0 plus 4 is 4. And if x is 2, y would have to be 2, because 2 plus 2 is also 4. So let's go ahead and plot these two points. Here's the point 0, 4. Here's the point 2, 2. Let's go ahead and graph the first line. Now for the second line, we have 4x minus 3y equals 9. For this line, let's go ahead and put it in slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b. So we'll take this equation here and solve for y. So if we have 4x minus 3y equals 9, to solve for y, we'll first subtract 4x on both sides. So we'd have negative 3y equals, we'll put the x term first, so negative 4x plus 9. And now we'll divide everything by negative 3. So we'd have the equation y equals, this would be positive 4/3 x, and this would be minus 3. So now we'll plot the y-intercept of negative 3, and then use the slope of 4/3 to find another point on the line. So here's the y-intercept. Now we'll go up 4 and right 3. We go up 4 and right 3. Again, looks like we just found the point of intersection here. Let's go ahead and sketch the red line. Again, because there's one point of intersection, we have one solution, which would be the coordinates of this point of intersection. So we have an x coordinate of 3 and a y coordinate of 1. So this would be our solution. But if we wanted to, we could also give the solution as x equals 3 and y equals 1. If we want to check this, we can. Notice if we substitute 3 for x and 1 for y, it satisfies equation 1. And then for equation 2, we'd have 4 times 3, that's 12, minus 3 times 1, or minus 3, and 12 minus 3 is equal to 9. And because this system has a solution, we can say it's consistent. And then because the equations are different, we can say the equations are independent. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.